Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Today we're going to make a breakfast sausage. Breakfast sausage is something that we've done on the channel in the past, and if you want to look back, I don't know, 2008 or 2009, there's a video of Julie and I making breakfast sausage. And we make a pork sausage, and the spice mix is ever evolving. As long as you follow a couple of easy guidelines. Oh, what's this? How'd that happen? What? Good thing I'm making sausage, because what I thought was a whole pork butt, which what was sold to me as a whole pork butt, has actually been cut into pork steaks. And they're pretty good looking pork steaks. So I could have pivoted if I had been if I'd been doing something else with this. Anyway, there's some guidelines you need to follow when you're making sausage. They're really easy. You essentially want 70% lean and 30% fat as your mix of meat. And it doesn't really matter where your fat comes from or where your lean comes from, whether it's pork or beef or chicken or turkey. You just kind of want that that mix. And you don't have to be overly strict about it. In that ballpark, and it's going to be fine. The next thing is your salt level. You want about 1.5 to 2% by weight of your mixture, of the meat mixture, should be salt. And if you're in that ballpark, everything is fine. And you want to add liquid. You always want to add either water or wine or beer or some liquid. And that's 2 to 3 tablespoons per pound. And I'll put all of that in the description box. So the first thing I'm going to do is just chop this up. And so you'll see a lot of sausage recipes that call for pork shoulder, pork butt, Boston butt, essentially all the same part, the front shoulder of the pig. They call for this cut for making sausages because it just naturally ends up as that 70-30 split of lean to fat. Now I'm cutting this up. I'm going to put this, first I'm going to weigh it so that I can figure out my spicing. Then I'm going to put this in the freezer for an hour or two. Not to freeze it all the way through, but just to keep it really cold because you get a much better grind that way. While the pork's in the freezer chilling down, we'll make the breakfast sausage spice blend. And I'm going to start out with the classics. I have rosemary, thyme, and sage. Essentially poultry seasoning. That is pretty much the starting point of every North American breakfast sausage, or what in Canada and the United States we would associate with breakfast sausage. To that, I'm going to add ground black pepper, dried garlic, paprika, red pepper flakes, coarse salt, brown sugar. Brown sugar is optional. And I sort of go back and forth on whether I add the brown sugar or don't add the brown sugar. It's totally up to you whether you want to put it in or not. I mean, sausage by its very nature is optional. Everything is an option. I'm going to put it in today and we'll see what happens. So that goes in and I just mix this together. And you don't have to worry about mixing it too much. The real mix will come together when we put it through the grinder with the pork. So let's get the grinder ready. So the pork cubes are partially solid at this point. I'm going to take the sausage spice mix and put it in there at this point. And I just feel that putting the spice mix onto the cubes of meat before we do the first grind will help to mix the spices in a little bit better. Who knows? So this is the bowl it's all going to come out into, and turn it on. Okay, I'm going to put this back in the freezer while we swap out the grinding disc. Okay, the grinder is unplugged and we're going to change out the grinding disc. For the initial grind, I used this one, which is fairly coarse. It is an 8.5 or 9 millimeter. For the second grind, I'm going to use this one. It is much finer and it is a 2 millimeter. So that goes on. All And we are ready to go. Okay, second grind. I have some ice water. You could use ice chips if you wanted to. I'm just gonna pour some ice water over the top. And away we go with the second grind. Okay, so at the end, when you've fed it all through, there's still gonna be some in here that hasn't gone through for a second grind. I just take some out of the bin that's already been through for a second grind, put it back in, and that will just push that last little bit through, and then whatever's left in here doesn't matter because it's already been ground twice. So, I'm gonna take this, I'm gonna stick it back into the fridge, I'm gonna keep it cool until I can get the sausage stuffer ready. You can emulsify this further if you want to, but for me, this is kind of the right consistency, and it holds onto my hand if I hold it upside down. So I'm gonna leave it just the way it is. So I'll see you back here when the stuffer's set up. You don't have to stuff this into casings. Some of this sausage I will keep out and just put into little Tupperware containers and stick it in the freezer. I keep some for patties, and I also use this in my turkey stuffing. And I really like it in my turkey stuffing. So I'm gonna put this into the stuffer and away we go. Now when you're loading the stuffer, you wanna pack it in fairly tightly. You don't want any air pockets because that will make a mess of your casings. Okay, putting the casing on the horn can be fiddly, especially if you don't do it every day. And since this casing didn't tell me what size, so I wasn't sure which size horn to use, but I think I've got the right one. Just take your time. I know you see people on YouTube doing this really quickly. They probably do it hundreds of times every day, day in, day out. Tie a little knot. It can be difficult. Pull it back onto the horn. Try to keep very little air bubble here at the end if you can. And then fill the casing. If you're like me, after you've got them stuffed, there will be air bubbles. So just take a little pin and puncture the casing just to let the air out. This will make it better when you go to cook them. Hey, Jules.
Hi, Glen. You've been busy today. Hey, friends.
Breakfast sausage.
Who doesn't love breakfast for supper?
I love breakfast for supper. I really do love breakfast for supper. And this is one of my favorite sausages.
Breakfast sausage? Yes, it is one of his. I concur.
Whether it's in a fat link, a little tiny little skinny link, if it's a patty, if it's in turkey stuffing, I don't care. I absolutely love breakfast sausage.
And joy on your face, yeah. Uh-huh.
I really like that. It's got a little bit more kick. If you go way back on the channel, we did a breakfast sausage recipe.
The Way Back Machine?
Way back. And it was essentially this, except I didn't put in the hot pepper.
Yeah, the hot pepper's nice, actually. Yeah. I really like that. It's nice, and it's a nice smooth texture to it without... Because sometimes breakfast sausages are super fatty.
Yeah.
And we're like, oh,
Yeah, this is really nice. And so, kind of play with the salt level, play with the spicing level, give it a shot. You don't have to put it in casing. If you want to just grind up the meat and then spice it and put it into a patty, fry it up and give it a taste.
Meatballs.
Meatballs.
Meatloaf.
Meatloaf. All of those things.
Ooh. Now I'm thinking like... breakfast meatloaf, like and there's some egg on top,
exactly.
And maybe some tomato. Ooh.
So
see, inventions all the time, and you know there's a recipe somewhere.
Someone's already made it. There's some breakfast spot somewhere that already does that.
Yep.
Yeah. So thanks for stopping by. Stay safe. See you again soon.